everyone. My name is Shubhangi Shivastav and today we are going to be discussing the topic epistasis. So earlier when Mendel published his findings in 1865, he assumed that the characters or the traits that were being passed on to the next generation were being governed by the expression of a single gene which had two alleles, one being dominant over the other. Later it was discovered that the development of certain characters was controlled by not just one but one or more than one genes. This could not be explained by Mendelian genetics, and due to this several different phenotypic ratios arrived which differed from the Mendelian ratios. Now to explain this, in 1909 William Batson and R.C. Burnett proposed the factor hypothesis, where they explained that the genetic genetic interaction. They stated that certain characters are governed by the expression of two or more genes. To talk more about these genetic interactions, they can be of two types: intra-allelic and non-allelic. For an example, let's say we have gene 1 and gene 2. When we talk about the interaction among these two genes, these two alleles, we are talking about intra-allelic interactions. But when we talk about the interaction among gene 1 and gene 2, then we are talking about non-allelic interactions. One such non-allelic interaction is epistasis. So what is epistasis? It is basically the interaction between two non-allelic genes where the phenotypic expression of one gene is being suppressed or masked by the other gene. The gene that is doing the masking is termed as the epistatic gene, while the gene that is getting masked is termed as the hypostatic gene. Moving on to the type of different epistatic interactions, they include dominant epistasis, recessive epistasis, duplicate dominant and duplicate recessive epistasis, dominant inhibitory epistasis, and polymeric gene interaction. In our video, we are going to be talking about all of these different types of epistasis. Beginning with dominant epistasis. What happens in dominant epistasis? So when a dominant allele of one gene is suppressing not only its own recessive gene but also the dominant and recessive alleles of another gene. As we can see in the example of summer squash, three colors are present: yellow, white and green. And in this we can see that the capital W, that is the dominant allele of the white gene, the epistatic gene. So anywhere that capital W is present, only and only the white phenotype will be expressed, no matter whether the capital G gene is present for yellow color or both small g is present. Whenever capital W is present, it will suppress the expression of the gene expressing for yellow color, that is the G gene. In case of absence of the epistatic gene, if capital G is present, then its phenotype yellow color will be expressed, while in a double homozygous recessive condition, an entirely different phenotype, green color, will be expressed. As we can see in this Punnett square, anywhere, wherever capital W is present, only a white phenotype is being seen. Such a condition leads to deviation from the typical Mendelian ratio, that is 9:3:3:1. As we can see here, only three yellow color genes are yellow colored phenotypes are present, while only one green fruit is present, and the rest all 12 are white fruits due to the masking of the G gene by the dominant epistatic gene. Moving on to the next gene interaction, recessive epistasis. In the last case, we saw the epistatic gene being the dominant allele. In this case, we are saying that the recessive allele of one gene is suppressing the action or the expression of another gene. You might be wondering, how can a recessive gene be dominant over a dominant gene? So let us understand this from an example of the coat color in Labrador retrievers. These dogs may be black, brown or yellow. Now two genes are involved in this, capital B and small b, where gene 1 expresses the coat color, that is capital B expresses black coat color while small b codes for brown coat color. While another gene where the alleles are capital E and small e allows the deposition of these colors once coded. Now if capital E is present, then these colors will be deposited and hence expressed. But let's say in a condition where capital E is absent, then only capital small e will be present, which would not allow the deposition of these colors, leading to a lighter colored phenotype. We can see in this example, wherever capital B is present and capital E is present, then the B color, the black color, is being coded and expressed. In a recessive condition, brown color is being expressed because capital E is still present. But in a case when there is a homozygous recessive condition, no matter whether capital B is present here or it is a homozygous recessive condition for the B gene, only yellow color will be expressed because the pigments are not being deposited. From this we can see that small e is masking the effect of this B gene and hence leading to a deviated ratio from the typical Mendelian ratio 9:3:3:1, where anywhere capital E is present, then only these are being expressed, but in recessive conditions only the yellow or the light color is being expressed, and the expression of capital B, even the dominant or the recessive one in the other gene, is being masked. Moving on to the next type of interaction, duplicate double dominant epistasis. In this epistasis, there is a condition that when a dominant allele at one of the two loci is present, then it will show a particular phenotype. Let's say we have two genes, G1 and G2. If either of these dominant genes are present, then a certain phenotype will be expressed. But in case of absence of both of these genotypes, an entirely different phenotype will be expressed. So how do we understand the epistatic interaction here? In here, wherever the capital A or capital B gene is present, it is masking the expression of all the small a or small b, that is the recessive genes, meaning that not only capital A is hiding the expression of its own recessive allele, it is also hiding the expression of the recessive gene of another allele. To understand this further, let's see the Punnett square, where anywhere either one of the dominant gene is present, the on character in rice is being expressed, while in cases where in only case where both the dominant genes are absent, then only an onless rice is being produced. From this we can see that capital A is not only suppressing the expression of its own gene, but it is also suppressing the action of the recessive allele of the other gene as well. Duplicate recessive epistasis. In this epistasis, if we compare to the last case, in the last case we saw that presence of either of the dominant gene made possible the expression of one phenotype, while a homozygous recessive condition only in both the genes resulted in a different phenotype. In this condition, we can see that the expression of both the dominant genes together will lead to a purple flower in the sweet pea plant. While if either one of the dominant gene is present, then only a white phenotype will be expressed. So from this we can see that even though a dominant gene is present, it is not being expressed. Why is it not being expressed? Because the recessive homozygous condition in small b is masking the expression of capital A, leading to a white phenotype. To see this in the Punnett square, as we can see, wherever both the dominant genes are present, then a purple phenotype is being shown. While only the presence of one dominant gene is being masked by the recessive genes of the other gene. We can see this in the case of purple as well, in the P gene being recessive as well, in the case of C gene being recessive as well. Only a white phenotype is being expressed, leading to a deviated ratio of 9:7. Moving on to the next type of gene interaction, dominant inhibitory epistasis. In this case, a dominant allele is masking the expression of the dominant and recessive alleles of another gene. Sounds similar to dominant epistasis, right? So the main difference between these two is the main function of the epistatic gene here is inhibition of the hypostatic gene, or the gene that is expressing a different kind of phenotype. Let's say there is a dominant phenotype. In anthocyanin pigmentation in rice, we can see this example. The green color of plant is the dominant phenotype, while another phenotype of purple color could be expressed in presence of P gene, but the I gene inhibits the expression of P gene. So in any case, wherever capital I is present, it will inhibit the expression of purple gene and hence result in a green colored phenotype. It will mask the expression of both the dominant and the recessive alleles of the purple gene. And only in a condition where there is a homozygous recessive condition for the I gene, the purple color will be expressed. So what it is doing? This dominant allele is masked, is inhibiting the expression of a certain gene. Hence, dominant inhibitory epistasis. To see this in the Punnett square, as we can see, wherever capital I is present, it is giving a green colored phenotype, while wherever a homozygous recessive condition is present for the I gene, a purple phenotype is being expressed. You can get confused with this block as well, where even though there is a homozygous recessive condition for both the genes, the inhibition action is not being performed due to recessive condition in I gene, while the purple gene is also not being formed due to recessive condition in P gene. And still we are seeing a green colored expression. Why is this green colored? Because as we mentioned earlier, green was the dominant phenotype. So in case a different phenotype is not being expressed, a green color is still seen, leading to a phenotypic ratio of 13:3. Now moving on to our last type of gene interaction for today, polymeric gene interaction. In this case, two alleles, when performing their actions separately, have a different effect. Seeing the example of fruit shape in summer squash, when capital A works alone, it expresses a sphere-shaped phenotype. When capital B works alone, it expresses again a sphere-shaped phenotype. But when these two work together, when they are present together in a genotype, then a disc-shaped fruit is formed. While in a homozygous recessive condition, a special phenotype, that is the long and rare case, long-shaped phenotype is being expressed. To see this in the Punnett square, as we can see, wherever both of these are present, both the dominant alleles are present, they are showing a disc-shaped phenotype. But in cases where, let's say, only B, capital B is present, sphere-shaped is observed. Only capital A is present, sphere-shaped is again observed. And in case of a homozygous recessive condition for both the genes, a long-shaped fruit is obtained, leading to a ratio of 9:6:1. From this, we got to see about different gene interactions and how the epistatic gene suppresses the hypostatic gene. Thank you for watching.